In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the files section within bCourses. So let's start by going over here to the menu. I'm going to select files. All right, so this is the files main page right here. Over here on the left-hand side, you have your folder structure. Right now, it's pretty empty because the course site is relatively new. So the first folder is always the title of your course, and you can also access files from your account right here, and that would show you files from your personal file section and also from any other course site that you're an instructor on, okay? So, but for now, we're just gonna talk about the file section for a single course. Okay, so how do we upload files so that we can share them with students? All you have to do, click on this little upload button right here. I'll select that. I'm gonna go to the area on my computer where I have a bunch of files. So I'll take the syllabus right here, and let's see what else. I'm gonna take some of these documents here. I'm holding down the command key to do this. It might be control if you're on a Windows computer. So I'm gonna select, you don't have to do multiple files. You can do one at a time if you like, but I'm selecting multiple files right here. And then I'm going to, now that I've got all my files selected, I'm gonna hit open. All right, so now what I have is in this root folder, I have all these additional PDFs. And then I have this one folder here for uploaded media. The uploaded media folder is simply a folder that contains images and things that you've uploaded to certain pages or areas of your course site. It's by default not visible to students from the file section. If you go to, for example, there's an image in here for one of the pages that I've created. When they go to that page, they'll see it. But when they're browsing through the file section, they don't see this uploaded media folder. So they will see these documents here that I've just uploaded. So let's say you'd like to organize this. So what you can do is you can add folders. So I'll hit this plus folder button and I'm going to call this unit one. Okay. So now I have a folder for unit one and I'm going to take this timing exercise PDF right here. I'm just gonna click and drag it into unit one. So I'm clicking, holding, and dragging and drag that into unit one. Right here, it looks like I've uploaded a file that I actually didn't want. That's no problem, I can easily delete it. I can go over here to these three dots and select delete and confirm that. And then I've got my Animator Survival Kit, that's our textbook. So I'm gonna leave that on the root folder there. And I'll also leave the Art of Animation 1 syllabus in the root folder. Now, it's entirely up to you how you'd like to structure these folders, but I just wanna show you, you know, if you have a lot of files, you're probably gonna want to create multiple folders. Like for example, I'm creating a folder for each unit. Right now, I just have a few documents here. So let's see, squash and stretch. I'll do slow in, slow out. It's going to be unit two, and squash and stretch is going to be unit three. So I'm just clicking and dragging these files, and I can click on a folder and I can see what's inside that folder. Okay, I can also access things over here. I can look at unit two, unit three, unit one. So now I just have my textbook here and I've got my syllabus here. And over here, you can see all of these files are published, which means it's visible to students. When they come to the file section of your course site, when they're logged in, they come in, they're gonna see these files right over here. All right, so let's say you want to link to a file from one of your pages. So I'm gonna go back over here to the pages section. I'll select that from the menu. And then I'm gonna select view all pages. And then from here, I'm going to go to this page that I created in a previous video, Welcome to the Art of Animation. Okay, so here I've got a page. Here's that image that I was talking about earlier. That image is located in the uploaded media section. Right down here in my introduction page here, I have the textbook is available in PDF format. I have this line right here on this page. And what I'd like to do is link to that textbook. So what I'm going to do is I'll go up to the top of the page here. I'll select Edit. Now inside the Rich Content Editor, I'm going to select textbook right here. Okay. And then what I can do is I can go up here to this little icon right here, this little document icon, and I can select that and go down to, I'm going to select course documents. What that's going to do is it's going to show me all of the files that I have in the file section. So I can then select the textbook file right here. And I can see now this is highlighted over here. There's an underline right there. So I've now added that link. So I can close this. I can save the page right here. And then if I select this right here, I can see that there's actually a link there. It's going to take me to that PDF. Okay, so that's actually not the textbook, that's just a blank file here, but you get the idea. All right, so I'm going to go back to the files homepage here. Now, there's one more thing I want to say before we wrap up, and that is the files section is really for documents. If you want to store video, there's a separate area inside bCourses to do that, and we'll cover that in the next video.